Burning a CD of your finished Pro Tools mix is easier than ever. If you own an iPod, then you most certainly have iTunes installed on your computer. Now, in the exporting audio movie, I bounce my mix into my music library directly from Pro Tools SE. I created a Pro Tools bounces folder, and inside that is my mix. It's a WAV file, CD quality. I'm going to right-click on it and choose Open with iTunes. iTunes opens and my mix is imported into my iTunes library. Now I can view it by list, icon view, or in cover flow mode. Nice. Now I'm going to close the Genius section so that we've got more room to work. Now before burning, I want to tag my WAV file, right-click it and get info. Click the info tab at the top and start filling in the relevant information. Artist, the year, the album, the composer and the genre. In the options tab, you can make volume adjustments. You can add an EQ preset, won't be needing that of course, and you'll want to rate the song. There's a few more options, but basically that's it. Mix, tagged. Name, artist, and album. Now I'm just going to come up and right click on the title column so that I can enable kind. That way I can identify that it's a WAV file. Grab the song and drag it into the playlist area. Let it go and a playlist will be created. Click on it and you'll see your song. So again, we took a file from the main library and dragged it and made a playlist. Now come down to the bottom and click Burn Disk. Fast as possible, and it's going to be an audio CD. There are other options, but ours will be an audio one and it will play in any CD player. Hit Burn and your CD tray will open. Put a blank in, close the tray, and the CD will start to burn. When complete, the CD will mount under devices on the left-hand side. So again, main library, the master file, playlist with the same song, and the burned CD version. Fantastic.